Sky Sports News, but better. Why are we better? Because you have Ollie McJolly as your transfer gossip host. Today, we're going to talk about Paul Pogba. We're going to talk about Jesper Cillessen, Matthias De Ligt, and a whole host of other footballers who are well overpaid and do not deserve our time or effort, but we give them it. Why, I hear you ask? Because we are fickle idiots who love football. Sorry, I spoke out loud then. I'm not calling you a fickle idiot. I'm talking about myself. Let's move on with the show. The show must go on. Go on, we will. Okay. Actually, I might go back to the shades. There we go. Let's see. I like the look. Yes. Shades it is. Ollie McJolly, the shade wearing fashion icon. Well, hell yeah. So, to start off, top of the bill, top of the headlines, we have Paul Pogba's proposed move to the mighty Blyth Spartans. Now, it's been reported that Blyth Spartans are just short of hitting his release clause. So far, they have offered four meat and potato pies, three bags of chips, and two cans of Diet Coke. Why only two cans of Diet Coke? I don't know. Surely they need four. If there's four pies, you have four cans of Coke. They're offering two. Man United have said you can have him, but you have to also accept to pay his taxi fare. Now, I'm not too sure how far it is from Manchester to Blyth, but if it's anything like a taxi fare around here, that could be rather expensive, and that could actually be the stumbling block on this deal going through. It is reported that Paul Pogba would rather have a move to Kettering Town. Apparently he has fond memories of holidays in Kettering when he was younger. But we are yet to see if Kettering will make a move or if they will sit back and let Blyth Spartans get for a couple of mouldy old pies, some bags of chips and a couple of cans of Coke. Moving on from Paul Pogba, we have talk and rumours of Donnarumma. Yes, I know it sounds like an 80s disco song, but Donnarumma and his proposed move to PSG. Moneybags, Paris Saint-Germain. If you actually think about it, if you actually talk about it, you don't just say Paris Saint-Germain. As a child, I would go around saying, hey, Ronaldinho plays for Paris Saint-Germain. But yeah, think about it. Think really, really closely, guys. Really, really, really closely, yeah. It's actually Paris Saint-Germain. If you say it a little bit slower, take it back real slow. Real slow. It's Paris Saint-Germain. Then you say it a little bit quicker like this, a little bit quicker. Paris Saint-Germain. I still say Paris Saint-Germain. Why? I don't know. But I just know that's what I say. So Donnarumma is rumoured to be on his way to Paris Saint-Germain in a switch deal plus money for Areola. Yes, Areola, the PSG keeper, would make way for Donnarumma, as well as a reported 20 million euros. Now, if AC have anything about them, let's lose the shades, guys. That ain't gonna work. Yeah, okay, let's pop them there. That's better. his way to PSG. Which can only be good news for Man United, as PSG have been long time rumoured to be interested in David De Gea, or David De Gea, or David De Gea, David De Gea, who is United's keeper, and United, although he had a clanker last season for about 6 months, will be hoping to keep David De Gea, who is still potentially the best keeper in the world, potentially. Okay, he had a few months break, but he's still good enough to be the best in the world. We have news on Lukaku and Inter Milan's cheeky little bit. He's a little bit cheeky, isn't he? He's just a little bit, just a tiny little bit cheeky, guys. They are offering $9 million for 2 years on loan with the option to buy at the end for $54 million. That's what's been reported. Where the hell do these clubs get the cheek? If Manchester United wanted to sell Lukaku, who they paid $74 million for just 2 years ago, why the hell would they say, yes, that's a great idea. You have him for $9 million for 2 years. 2 years for $9 million. We will go out and buy another striker for $100 million. We only have to put $91 million towards the deal. Why didn't we think about that before? Wow. Inter, you're so friendly. You're so kind to us. Thank you. Thank you for helping us out like that. Do I see the deal going through like that? No. In hell's chance do I see that happening. Inter will have to stump up the 70 odd million, mostly it up front, to get that deal over the line. The tight kids. Jesper Cillessen has completed a £31 million move, or euro move, not pound. Sorry, Oleg McJolly made a mistake there. It's euros. Yes, I should know. I'm about to buy some today for my holiday next week. I am sunning it up in the Costa del Mallorca. Yes, yes I am. Yes, Mr. Listen, the backup for long periods at Barcelona to Ter Stegen has joined Valencia, where he'll become their number one goalkeeper, in what I feel is a great move for the lad and a great move for Valencia. And for $31 million, when you look at Kepa the keeper, $70 odd million, Alisson, $70 odd million, De Gea, $100 million possibly, Jordan Pickford, $30 million, $31 million for the Dutch national keeper isn't too bad. We have Jack Clark, young Jack Clark, who looks like he should still be eating his chips and peas at lunch break at school, whilst getting ready for his bloody mock exams in year 10. He has just about signed an $8.5 million deal to play for the mighty Tottenham Hotspur. The Spursies. Yes, he's signed for the mighty Whites down in North London. There is talk that Tottenham and Mauricio Pochettino in particular wants to send him back to Leeds United, where his old mentor Marcelo Bielsa would continue to work with Jack Clark for another season. This, I feel, would be a good move for all parties concerned. They are also on the verge of signing Ndombele. Ndombele sounds nice, don't it? Oh, I'll have an Ndombele to go, please. Yes, Ndombele from Lyon. Olympic Lyonnais from France. Francais, yes. And that deal is just being dragged on a little bit now because Daniel Levy likes to drag it out. He's probably arguing over the cost of a suit. Lyon are like, we want you to pay for his presentation suit. Daniel Levy's like, only if it's from Primark. Lyon are like, we don't care where it's from. And Dumbele's like, hell no, I want Gucci, my son. a sundae. That's called coochie, not coochie. Coochie. You'll never know the difference. And Mbele, I'll get you on there, mate. Leroy Sané to Bayern Munich. This story will just not go away, guys. Bayern Munich apparently are desperate to get themselves a young winger. Well, they've lost two, haven't they? They lost Franck Ribéry and Arjen Robben. They still have Kingsley Coman. And they're trying to do a deal for either Callum Hudson-Odoi, who they've now bid for four times, guys. Or they're after Leroy Sané, who apparently wants to join Bayern Munich. So, do Man City keep hold of a player who don't want to be there? I don't know. Can they keep hold of him? I don't know. Will they keep hold of him? I don't know. Will Bayern Munich sign him? I don't know. Will they bid for him again? I just don't know. Joao Felix, who is a walking advertisement for dental hygiene as he wears braces. A young kid who looks like he should still be eating Knickerbocker glories. Everyone remember those Knickerbocker glories? That big ice cream thing in my mum's. And he should be sitting there doing that alphabet spaghetti. Yes. Instead, he's just completed a hold the back page. He has just completed a 120 million euro deal to Atletico Madrid. 120 million euros to Atletico Madrid. Now, here at Ollie's Sports News, I, Ollie McJolly, only make about £120 a month for doing the show. He has been paid £120 million, well, the club have, just to play football. I don't even dare think what he's on wage wise. Now, this is a kid I seen him with my own two eyes, play for Portugal in the recent Nations League finals, and the lad was anonymous. That's a hell of a lot of money to pay for an anonymous player. And will there be a big sell on from that? You gotta think that they'll be looking at 200 million if they're gonna sell him eventually. 200 million. But he has to prove he's worth that first. I think that's a hell of a risk Madrid have taken there. We have news. Kovacic has signed for Chelsea. Now, the way this works is, yes, Chelsea have a transfer ban for being naughty boys. They were naughty boys, you bad boys. You bad, bad boys, Chelsea. They spent money they should not have spent because they did not have it to spend, basically. But they were not allowed to sign any players. But the rules were bent a little bit. A bit like Chelsea as a club. A little bit bent. They were allowed to sign a player or players if they were already registered for the club. Mateo Kovacic was on loan from Real Madrid at Chelsea last season. So he was registered with the club. So they was able to complete that deal. But 40 million euros is a lot of money for a bang average midfielder. They've already got enough of those in at their club. Harry Maguire, a player who a lot of us forget was relegated just like 2 years ago with Hull City. Yes, he was. Old big head, as hard as Cox, he's got a big head on him. Was relegated with Hull City just 2 years ago. Leicester went and signed him for next to nothing. And now apparently he's worth 100 million euros. Seriously. That is what they're talking about at Leicester. They're saying, you want Harry Maguire? We want 100 million euros. And that's there. That's the bottom line. Because Leicester City said so. 100 million euros. I'm like, honest to God, you're asking for that. Bear in mind, okay, Virgil van Dijk, Big Verge, Big Van, Big Dyke, was about 75 million quid, or euros, £75 million. Down the pan, sharp left, to Liverpool from Southampton. And yes, he was an unknown quantity in the respect that we did not know he'd be this good, but I think we kind of knew. And yet, Harry Maguire, I don't see as good as Virgil van Dijk. I don't see him being as good as Buddy West Morgan at Leicester, pretty much. 100 million. Ooh, someone's going to get stung if they do that deal, whether it be Manchester United or Manchester City. One of them two clubs will do that deal, and he's going to set them back 100 million euros. Ooh, prepared to have your bum spanked. Successor to Bonucci, and that is Matthijs de Ligt. 60 odd million they're talking about, with redonkulous wages. Like, hold the back page. This lad has only had a good season at Ajax. He's not had a good season in the Premier League. Careful what you're paying for there, Juve. We just look decent, to be fair. Vandenberg. Liverpool have signed the ginger Virgil van Dijk, this young kid, 17 years old, signed from Zwolle in Holland, Amsterdam, well, I don't think he was from Amsterdam, is he, but from Holland anyways, and his name is Vandenberg, and he's a big old kid with ginger hair. You will not miss him on a dark night, trust me. Torreira, young Torreira, who Arsenal only signed last season, is on the verge of, well, he wants to anyway, join AC Milan. Now, he cannot be for European football because Arsenal have that. Okay, it's the European Tin Cup that they are in, but they're still in something. AC Milan were meant to be in the Europa League, but were kicked out the other day due to financial issues they've caused for themselves under the previous management. So he'll be going there to play just Italian League football and Cup football. But apparently I can say ciao bella. I can't say, can I have a tomacalacalato in Italian, but I can't say ciao bella, get me the bangers and mash. Yes. We have news on Rabiot to Juve on a free transfer. Surprise, surprise, Juve pull off another coup. Another free transfer. Who's that now? Aaron Ramsey, Adrian Rabiot, Emre Can last season, and there's another one whose name escapes me. All on free transfers. Oh, Buffon is gone back there on a free transfer. It's crazy. They are building a squad without spending any transfer fees. Zaha to Arsenal, 40 million. They have bid. That is Stan Kroenke's bid. That is crackers. It's Kroenke's. It is absolutely off. They're off their heads. It's like when they tried to get Luis Suarez for 39, was it 40 million in a pound? When the release clause was like 45 million or something like that. And they bid 40 million in a pound. You're not going to get Wilfred Zaha for less than United got Wan-Bissaka. Especially as United have a 25% sell on clause in that deal from when they sold it back to Palace. So if it goes for 40 million, United get, what, 10 million. So Palace will not be happy with that deal. They'll be looking closer to 80 million, I'm guessing, for a player who is bang average, a great penalty winner, and a serial moaner and complainer. He should fit in right well at Arsenal. Cancelo from Juve to Manchester City for 54 million to solve their right back problem. Their right back problem being Kyle Walker isn't that good anymore. Now I'm joking, for we all have a hernia. Of course he's good, but let's be honest, Cancelo looked pretty damn good as well for Juve last season at right back. We have Rafa Benitez, not in transfer news, but Rafa Benitez, his contract ended with Newcastle on Sunday. He came out with a statement yesterday on Twitter, on the Twitter. He said, Newcastle didn't share my vision. I like a good project. Basically, he said he likes a good jigsaw. Well, I've got a few upstairs he can have. So he comes out and says that, and then in the next breath, he goes and signs for a Chinese team for 12 million a year, kind of ruining any respect he had with the Newcastle fans, I'm guessing. Because where the hell is a project when you're signing for 12 million a year to play, to manage in China? A league where Benitez could probably get the old kit out, dust it off, and still be the star player in the team. What a joke. Aston Villa have, ironically, dealt their bitter rivals Birmingham City a huge blow. So Villa signed young target from Southampton. Is it Matt Target? I think so. They signed young target from Southampton for like 11 to 15 million. If it's 11 million, rising to 15 million. Southampton then went and used that money straight away. Thank you, Villa. Hello, Birmingham. We're just going to pop up the road now from Villa Park to St Andrews, or it used to be St Andrews. I don't know what it's called anymore. And we're going to go and sign their star striker, Shay Adams. Villa are there like, oh, you're popping off the road. Ah, great stuff. Pop in the ball ring whilst you're there. Pick up a Birmingham City shirt. Get Villa on the back. Hand it off when you sign Shay Adams, please. Shay Adams signs for, I think it's 14/15 million with Southampton. A great signing for them. Arsenal are in Brahimi talks. Who, I hear you ask? I thought the same. A 29-year-old free agent who recently left Porto. Scored a few goals. Algerian international. Arsenal looking to do things on a budget once again. And Brahimi could be the answer. Marcus Rashford signs a new deal with Man United for a reported holding. last season. By all intents and purposes, he's now been rewarded with a $300,000 a week deal. Absolutely horrendously ridiculous. Philip Cocu to Derby. Derby, need a new manager. Lampard on his way to Chelsea. They go and call up Cocu. Cocu, hello, Philip. Would you please come and manage us? Philip Cocu. Cocu. I don't know. Have a think about it. We have news on free transfers. I'm going to give you a 1 to 11 of free transfers, free agents right now. We have in goal Michel Vorm. Vormy. Old Vormy Wormy. From what he was at Tottenham. Now he's a free agent. At right back, we have Daniel Alves. Yes, Danny Alves. Centre back, Gary Cahill. Gary Cahill, yes. Alongside him, we have Thomas Vermaelen. The Belgian centre back has been released by Barcelona. At left back, we have the mighty Alberto Moreno, who, when Liverpool in the Champions League recently, was celebrating like he'd won the scored the winning goal, when in matter of fact he hadn't played in God knows how many weeks. He did a John Terry. On the right wing, we have Hatem Ben Arfa, who was recently released by somebody. I think he was released by, I think he was offering like Al Jazeera somewhere, I don't know, somewhere like that. Central midfield, we have Danielson. Arsenal fans will remember him fondly. We have Johan Kebab. Yes. Johan, would you like a kebab? Yes, okay then. We have Franck Ribéry on the left wing, who's released by Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich. And up front we have Danny Sturridge and Danny Welbeck. The two Dannys, the double D's, both should have as their middle name Danny, always injured. Sturridge, Danny, always injured. Welbeck. And on our subs bench we have Arjen Robin. We have Mario Balotelli, he's a free agent, believe it or not. We have Albert Adoma from Villa. We have Jason Puncheon, ex Palace player, was on loan last season at Huddersfield. We have Bakary Sakho, who just couldn't do it at Palace, unfortunately. We have Phil Jagielka. We have Danny Simpson, the ex Leicester Premier League winner. We have Shinji Okazaki, who wanted to move for ages and ages from Leicester over the last couple of years, and now he can move where he wants because he's a free agent. We have Fernando Llorente, just left Tottenham. Samir Nasri, come back after his drug use, went to West Ham for a few months. They didn't keep him on because he needed his fix to get better, to play better. And we have, also from West Ham, big Andy Carroll. Yes, Andy Carroll. One of the biggest flops in Liverpool's history for the price they paid for him. You still got to laugh about that deal. You've got to laugh. Especially when Suarez only cost 24 million or something like that. And Carroll cost 30 odd million. Right then, guys. I've been your host, Ollie McJolly with the slanting shades. Ollie McJolly and Ollie's Sports News. Hell yeah, baby. I will be back this time next week with more Ollie's Sports News. Guys, hit that thumbs up, subscribe.